Greetings. Brother, we have now had many exchanges, many messages, many topics. But now I want to address one central topic directly. Telling lies. This is a central difference, brother, between Muhammad's religion and what the Son of God, Jesus, taught. You see, brother, Muhammad allowed lies, but Jesus did not. In Bukhari 52:269, we know the Prophet said war is deceit. In Bukhari 49:857, he who makes peace between people by inventing good information or saying good things is not a liar. Inventing means making things up. Telling falsehoods, brother, that means telling lies. There is a modern expression that says the end justifies the means. This excuses evil if it accomplishes something deemed to be good. We see this in politicians every day. They see no wrong in telling their lies because they think they are doing some good. But telling lies is forbidden by God, brother. Exodus 20:16, you shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. Colossians 3:9, do not lie to one another, since you laid aside the old self with its evil practices. Lies are an evil practice, brother. Leviticus 19:12, you shall not swear falsely by my name, so as to profane the name of your God. I am Yahweh, the Lord. Revelation 21:8, but for the cowardly and unbelieving and abominable and murderers and immoral persons and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars, their part will be in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Brother, look who liars are lumped in with. Unbelievers, idolaters, sorcerers. Not saints, brother, not believers. And the first of these is the cowardly. Now, wasn't one of the reasons Muhammad approved lies is for cowardice? Quran 3:28, let not the believers, meaning Mohammedans, take for friends or helpers unbelievers rather than believers. If any do that, in nothing will there be help from Allah, except by way of precaution, that you may guard yourselves from them. But Allah cautions you to remember Himself, for the final goal is to Allah. You can pretend to be friends with Jews and Christians if you are afraid. That means in your cowardice, brother. This is Muhammad teaching it is okay to be cowardly and lie. Or worse, Allah says to be a coward and lie. Please think about that, brother. The Word of God denounces liars with cowards and those doomed for the flames. Muhammad and the Quran say to lie out of fear or cowardice. And that is not the only point to the matter, brother. Matthew 10:32, therefore, everyone who confesses me before men, I will also confess him before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I will also deny him before my Father who is in heaven. Luke 12:8, and I say to you, everyone who confesses me before men, the Son of Man will confess him also before the angels of God. But he who denies me before men will be denied before the angels of God. You see, brother, Jesus said very clearly that if you deny him, he will deny you before God in heaven. And I just don't know how you can imagine that is the same as taqiyya and the lies that Islam allows. Quran 2:225, Allah will not take you to task for inadvertent statements in your oaths, but He will take you to task for the intention your hearts have made. Allah is ever forgiving, all forbearing. You know what this is describing, brother. You can say anything, as long as in your heart you do not mean what you say. That included cursing the Prophet to save yourself, doesn't it, brother? Ibn Sa'd, in his book Al-Tabaqat Al-Kubra, narrates on the authority of Ibn Sirin that the Prophet saw Amir ibn Yasir crying, so he wiped off his tears and said, "The non-believers arrested you and immersed you in water until you said such and such," bad-mouthing the Prophet and praising the pagan gods to escape persecution. "If they come back, then say it again." Jesus said, "Do not deny me." Muhammad said, "Deny me to save yourself and do it again if needed." The God of the Torah and Bible could not lie, brother. But Allah is called the best deceiver. Who do you worship, brother, if your Allah is the best deceiver? You have to think about what that really means, brother. Nothing Allah says may be trusted. Anything Muhammad claimed Allah said could be a lie. In all human matters, brother, do you trust anyone who has lied to you? Well, why, brother, do you hold people to a higher standard than Allah? Why do you follow a religion that allows lies as part of its dawa? If Islam will lie about one thing, what else has it lied about? I encourage you, brother, to seek the truth, because Jesus said, "I am the truth." John 14:6, Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me." May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.